Okay, so once we got to grips with variables and lists, we can start doing some more interesting things in Python. And what we're going to do is build a text adventure game, a bit like the old-fashioned sort of games you used to have on the computer years ago, where you have various options that you can take to get through the game. So we're going to start by setting some things, and we're going to say, let's call it lives, actually. So we've got lives equal to, let's say three lives, and we've got, actually let's call it points, zero. So what we're saying, at the start of our game, we've made two variables. One is called lives, which we've set to three, and that could go up or down depending on what happens in the game. And we've got points, okay, which is currently set to zero, and again, that can go up or down depending on what choices you make in the game. Now, like in all good adventure games, we need some kind of inventory of things. So we will have a rucksack, which will be a list, and that will be full of some magical items. So we'll have a key, which could be useful. We'll have a duck. You never know when you might need one. We'll have a brush. Oops, must put this in as a string. Okay, and we'll close off the list. Now, I'll show you a bit later, but you can add and subtract things from a list. So that our rucksack, our list of items, could get bigger or smaller. Okay. Now, in all good games, we need to start off by working out what the name of the adventurer is. So we're going to set a variable called name, and we're going to put an input statement. And again, we need an instruction to the user. So something like, type in the name of the adventurer, spell that correctly. Okay, and what we will need after that is then some kind of, prose, okay, so some kind of story. So here's one I made earlier. Okay, and I've got a print statement, and much like with our vegetable poem, I've got welcome in a string, and then a comma, and then name, so variable. So whatever we've typed in as the name will come up in this line, okay? So it's a sort of personalised game, all right? And then comma to this ancient kingdom full of magic and cornflakes. And then what I've done is used a print statement. Now you can see this print statement is quite long, okay? Now, what we can do, and I'll just explain how this works. If this was a kind of fairly standard print statement, you can see there it's going off the page. Okay, now that's quite difficult to work out what's going on, because we might miss a, you know, a speech mark or a bracket. So what we can do, if you've got a long string like I've got there, we can use triple quotation marks. And what triple quotation marks do is allow you to go down to the next line. So just to give you an example, if I just press enter, you can see there the line has gone kind of black and yellow and all that. And that's because it doesn't understand what's happening at the end of this line because there's no quotation mark. So if I ran this now, we'd come up with an error. Okay, EOL. And EOL means end of line. So in other words, it's looking through this string and it's getting to the end of the line and thinking, okay, I don't know what's going on here because you haven't put a speech mark. Okay, so say we put a speech mark there and ran it again, you can probably guess what's going to happen. We're going to get another error for the line below, okay, because we haven't told it what to do on this line. All right, so the way around this is, like I said, using triple quotation marks. So you start your line with three quotation marks, you end it with three quotation marks, and what that enables you to do is have as many lines as you like in between. Okay, so you can kind of set things out however you want. All right, so let's have a look now and see what happens. Okay, so Bob, there we go. So you can see there how it's set the line out. Rather than going kind of off the page, the triple quotation marks ensure that you can have a long line all put in so you don't have to scroll across. You can see also here our variable has worked, welcome Bob, welcome name, remember name was Bob. So we are kind of off and running with the first part of our adventure game.